Afternoon, YouTubers. Thank you for joining me. Don't forget to make sure you're still subscribed. A lot of people get unsubscribed because the AI for YouTube thinks you're a bot. And please share my videos. At 6:22 a.m. this morning, August 4th, 2022, there was an earthquake there close to the Seattle area. USGS said it was a magnitude 3.2. It was probably closer to a 3.4. 166 people sent in a report to USGS Did You Feel It website, said they did feel the shaking. Going to Google Earth, here's the location of that 3.2. And we'll bring it out a little bit so you can see. I downloaded two different monitors. I got one here close to Emu Claw. Is that actually how you pronounce the name of that town? And I also downloaded it from over here. Now, this one here is a borehole. Borehole 940. As you know, boreholes are wells about, 600 feet, maybe deeper, dug into the ground. So they supposedly don't pick up any outside, activity. And then over here, we got Mount Rainier. Here's a spectrogram from that borehole. And you can see at the bottom, MD. 3.41. And we'll go to its seismic signature. There it is. And let's extract that. What do we got? Some rounded tops, which would mean magma. Now, this earthquake was about 11 miles below sea level. Probably in an area where it's locked for subduction. And then we got some pointed ones, but most of them look like they're rounded, which would be probably down there in the subduction zone where the magma is trying to move the Pacific plate, subducting underneath the North American plate. So here's the two monitors. One on the left is the borehole. One on the right is from Emu. I'm just going to call it Emu. Reminds me of the ads on TV. On PNSN, there are 69 earthquakes reported here in the last 24 hours, but this is for the third. They're always 24 hours behind in the earthquakes. And let me bring it in. I'll give you a link to this website, and you can go check it out yourself. And then let me bring it up so you can put in whatever date you want, which would be up there. All right, so there's the earthquakes, a lot of magnitude ones, and of course they're not reporting them, and some smaller, 0.6, 0.8. Let me pull this over. This one here is a 1.0, a 0.9, a 0.8, and USGS doesn't really report any of these earthquakes. A 1.3. So going back to Google Earth, let's go to where Oak Harbor, Washington is, because those are the ones that they were mostly tracking. And up over there, you can see got a red line drawn out. And I don't think I have a name for that fault zone, but I got different fault zones drawn out. And we'll bring it out. Sixty-three earthquakes is a lot of earthquakes for one day. I mean, if USGS reported them all, it would just be a big mess. All right, so let's zoom into this area because, all right, so we got four earthquakes in the last 24 hours they got reported here. Mount St. Helens, a 0.4. Majority of the people said it was intensity level 3, and there was one intensity level of 4. And that was up by Lake Stevens, which would mean to those people there, it was felt indoors by many, outdoors by a few at night. Well, it was, 6:22 a.m.? They would have been woken up. Dishes, windows, doors were rattling, and automobiles would have been rocking noticeably. The majority of the people said it was felt noticeably indoors, intensity level 3. but not always recognized as an earthquake. Standing automobiles would have been rocking slightly, vibration like a passing truck. So did you feel this earthquake? If so, maybe you should send it into EMSC or USGS. USGS does not put what people actually feel like EMSC does. Please put those comments down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.